So, you are looking for a cheap budget capture card, you probably come across this HDMI video capture. That's a USB capture card. And by the time I upload this review, there are now two versions of it. The version that we are reviewing is the black one, which it supports 1080p 30fps, while the new coffee version support 1080p 60fps. There shouldn't be much difference between the two. So, if you are buying this now, get the coffee version. Okay, let's start with the unboxing. Inside the package, there are the capture card and a manual. First, let's take a look at the capture card. This is the front of the capture card. The back, the side, another side, the bottom, and the top. Then, let's take a look at the manual. Pause the video if you want to read it. Let's move on to the installation. First, plug in the capture card. We must pay homage to him. Then, plug in the HDMI cable. Before we continue, I noticed a problem right away. The capture card is nearly loose on my USB port. I tried changing to notebook USB port, and it's still a bit loose. Alright, to use this capture card, you can use it with any software that supports webcam. I will be teaching how to use it with OBS here. First, you need to add source by clicking the plus button, then click on video capture device. Click OK. Then choose the USB video as the device. Click OK again. The video should appear right away. As you can see, there is a video, but there is no audio. There are two ways we can fix this. The first way is to scroll down to the bottom and click the Use Custom Audio Device. Make sure it's Digital Audio Interface, USB Digital Audio. Now, there is audio. Awesome. But what if I don't want to use this way? Well, you can choose to add another source, which is Audio Input Capture. Click OK. Then choose the USB Digital Audio. Click OK. Now, there is Audio Input Capture, and you can hear the music that is now fading away. Enough for how to. Let's move on to the quality of this capture card. We are going to compare between OBS footage, which is 1080p 60fps, and USB capture card footage, which are 1080p 30fps and 720p 60fps. As you can see, there is difference in color, and the sharpness isn't as sharp as the OBS game capture, but it got really close. Remember, this capture card costs like $10. By the way, the desync is difference between 30fps and 60fps, not the capture card delay. Going to lower resolution, the sharpness drops a bit, but you get 60 FPS. To wrap it up, with 1080p, you get slightly blurred image from original, and with 720p, you get 60 FPS. If you go with the coffee version, I expect the image of 1080p to be the same, but with 60 FPS. Now, I also have DaVinci Resolve color collection setting to show you guys how close the color can get to the original. Just copy the values that I show here. Check out the difference. The color is pretty much the same now, right? Let's move on to the delay then. This capture card only has 48 millisecond delay, which is pretty darn good. The glitch that appeared on OBS screen was because I didn't pack the capture card tight enough. And finally, the audio is mono, not stereo. So keep that in mind if you are going to stream FPS game. Let's conclude with pros and cons. This capture card is a value for money. There's nothing cheaper than this. It captures nice, sharp 720p 60 FPS footage. It barely has any delay, and it's small, so it's portable. Now, for the cons. The USB port is loose, so you have to be careful. 1080p is more like 900p, so it is blurry, and it has mono audio. So with all these pros and cons, who do I recommend this capture card for? Well, I highly recommend this capture card to anyone who needs to turn the DSLR camera into a webcam. Since you don't need high detail for small face cam, then for secondary usage, you can use it for game capture. Since it can only capture sharp 720p 60 FPS, I would use it with game that doesn't need much detail, like a mobile game or a Nintendo Switch. Other than these two, I highly recommend this to anyone who just needs a capture card for pretty much anything. It's a capture card and it pretty much does its job. Is there really anything else to say about this? Well, yes, that brings us to the end of this video. If you like this video, then why not hit that like button? And hey, if you want to see more from me, then why not press that subscribe button? And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.
Whoa, that's so trippy.